إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد أيها المسلمون اتقوا الله حق التقوى واعلموا أن أجسادكم على الصراط لا تقوى قال تعالى واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. My brothers and sisters, Allah is our creator, subhana, and He has created the creation, and part of His creation is He alternates the day and the night. He has made the seasons to follow on from one another. And the purpose for all of this is that He is worshipped alone by man and jinn. Allah says in the Quran, وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ خِلْفَةً لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. Yes, my brothers and sisters, this week all of our lives changed from the qudra of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Our days have got longer and our nights have got shorter. But how is this connected to the purpose of our existence and the reason why we have been created? My brothers and sisters, the ulama of Islam are all agreed that the prayer times must be preserved by the Muslims at all times. Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةِ كَانَتْ أَلْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا. So it's not permissible for a person to become relaxed about his prayer times, or lazy, or even delay them. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, إِنَّ لِلصَّلَاةِ وَقْتًا كَوَقْتِ الْحَجِّ. What this means is that salat has a prescribed time, just like when the Muslims perform their hajj. It can only be performed in Dhul Hijjah. Likewise, the morning and the evening have been created and given to you by Al-Fatir Subhanah, so that you preserve your connection with Him, so that you remember Him and you don't forget Him, so that you thank Him and you are not ungrateful, so that you can improve yourself in your statements, in your actions, so that you can become better people, so that you can please Him and enter His Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man hafadha as-salawat al-khams," whoever preserves the five daily prayers, ruku'ihin, wasujudihin, wudu'ihin, mumaqitihin, its ruku's, its sujud, its wudu, and its prayer times, wa alima annahunna haqqun min indillah, and they realize that this is an obligation from Allah and it is something that they must preserve in themselves. They have no option in this in their lives. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, wajabat lahul jannah. Jannah becomes mandatory for this person. My brothers and sisters, Islam gives a great deal of importance to the salat. Without it, people will worship Allah only when they want to, or they will worship Allah according to their own terms and conditions. They will lose respect for themselves, they will lose respect for their Lord, for their religion, and they will lose respect for the rights of Islam. They will not be bothered whether they are upright in their statements or not. But also, the things needed for salat will also become absent in their life also. So for example, if a person has no reason to make tahara for salat, why else would he make tahara? Why else would he make dhikr? Why else would he recite the Quran? Why else would he supplicate and make dua to his Lord? And so on. And this is the very reason why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Man fatatu salat, if anybody misses one salat, just one salat, فَكَأَنَّمَا وُتِرَ أَهْلَهُ وَمَالُهُ, it is as if he has lost his family and his wealth. The Prophet ﷺ said, if you leave one salah out of laziness, out of neglect, or out of just no reason, it is as if you have lost everything. Without salat, the Prophet ﷺ is teaching us, your life will be hollow, it will become dark, it will become depressing, and you will lose any benefit in the dunya in the akhirah. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said, whoever leaves just one salat, that sin is so enormous, even if he wanted to make qada for that salat, he would not be able to do so. Even if he performed that one salat over and over again. The reason being, he has lost the time to pray. If he has lost the time, he has lost the reward. If he has lost the reward, he has lost the acceptance. My brothers and sisters, it is wajib upon every single one of us, male or female, young or elderly, to learn the prayer times to the best of our ability and to preserve them. Because every summer we have a time change, and every summer the same dispute arises. When do we pray Salatul Isha? When do we pray Salatul Fajr? The Prophet ﷺ also warned that if a person becomes negligent about his prayer times and he doesn't know if he is following the correct prayer times, or he is not preserving the prayer times in his life, his iman will become weak. His iman will become weak and his connection with his Lord will suffer. The Prophet ﷺ said, Tilka salatul munafiqeen. Tilka salatul munafiqeen. Tilka salatul munafiqeen. He said it three times. That is the salah of the munafiq. Yajlis ahaduhum hatta idha asfarat ash-shams. He sits and he waits and he delays the prayer for Salatul Asr until it is about to set and the sun is no longer hot anymore and it's become yellow. وَكَانَتْ بَيْنَ قَرْنَيْ الشَّيْطَانِ. And he only prays when it is between the horns of shaitan. What we learn from this is that a person, when he is not bothered about his prayer times, he will only pray when it suits him, or whenever he is told to pray, or whether he doesn't realize that the prayer times he is following is actually correct or not. As a result, the rest of the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ tells us his khushu in the salat, and the very essence of the salat in his life will be lost. Qam, for nakara arba'an, he prays and he stands and he pecks like a bird, pecks four times on the floor. La yathkuru Allah fiha illa qalila. He doesn't remember Allah and doesn't benefit from it except a little. And we also find in some of my brothers and sisters another situation of a different group of people when it comes to salat. Those people who stay up late, socializing and enjoying what they feel is mubah and permissible. They are affected by salah also. They become really relaxed also. Either they will stay up all night and they will say, let's pray Salatul Fajr and go to sleep. And what that means is they will end up sacrificing praying Salatul Dhuhr in the masjid, or even in its correct time, praying it very late in the day. Or you will find this group of people, they will not pray Salatul Isha or Salatul Fajr at its correct time, because of what is convenient for them. Yes, it's a very difficult situation, my brothers and sisters. But look what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us. And he said how we as adults should be responsible over our salat and teach our children. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Muru awladukum bisalat wa hum abna' sab'a sinin." Teach your children how to pray when they are 7 years old. "Wadribuhum alayha wa abna' ashrin." And if they get to the age of 10 years old, remind them. And the reason why is because children are forgetful. Children are immature. And children just want to spend their time enjoying and playing. But when it comes to the salat for the adults, the Prophet ﷺ is put us responsible over the children to teach them and to constantly remind them. So if this is the situation of the adult, and if this is the situation of those people who are 7 and 10 years old, how about the responsibility of the adult and the accountability when it comes to the salat himself? What answer will he give on a day when he will realize that salat will be nur, and this was his main hope of salvation, when he didn't preserve the prayer times himself and he acted irresponsibly, sometimes even worse than a 7-year-old and a 10-year-old? My brothers and sisters, salat is the very essence of the reason why the houses of Allah exist. And it's to Allah we complain. We find the houses of Allah have become empty. The masajid are losing their soul and their character. The masajid are losing their men and their purpose. The masajid are the houses of Allah. But what is the reward for the guest who comes to the house of Allah? It actually begins, my brothers and sisters, when you are sleeping on your bed. The Prophet ﷺ said, when you wake up in the morning and we remember Allah, the grip of shaitan is loosened. Inhallat uqda. When he makes wudu, inhallat uqda. Another grip of the shaitan is loosened. And when he prays the sunnah rawatib for fajr, Well, the Prophet ﷺ described خير من الدنيا وما فيها is better than the whole dunya and everything that's in it. In halut uqda, another grip of the shaitan is loosened. And his reward has already begun to come to the house of Allah. And he has already become successful. And he hasn't even left his house yet. But when he leaves his house to go to the house of Allah, the angels are waiting at his door and they accompany him until he enters the house of Allah. And they are supplicating for him, Allahumma ighfir lahu, Allahumma arham. And they continue supplicating for this person as long as this person is showing humility to Allah. Because yes, my brothers and sisters, going to the masjid itself is an act of worship. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam described going to the masjid itself, you are already in salat. So be careful, my brothers and sisters, in what you listen to, in what you look at, in the way that you behave when you are coming to the masjid. Then he enters the masjid and he joins the congregation. And when he prays in congregation, he gets 25 times the reward of praying alone. And this is added to the 50 that Allah has already promised for those people who pray 5 times a day. If the brothers can move forward, please. There's people waiting at the back. Then when he joins the imam and he starts praying with him, if his ameen coincides with the ameen of the angels, not only will his dua be accepted, but all of his previous sins will be forgiven. Until the imam finishes the prayer, and he finishes the prayer with the imam. And if he wants to, if he offers more nawafil and sunan prayers for every single letter of the Quran, he will get his reward multiplied by 10. My brothers and sisters, this is just one salat in the masjid with khushu and with ikhlas. Look at the effects that it has on a person. A person, if he preserves his times and his action, not only is he upholding for the reason why he has been created, but it will bring about the pleasure of his Lord. It will rectify his affairs. Allah will preserve you and your loved ones and your dunya and your akhirah. It will rid you from shaitan. It will make the angels your closest of companions. They will make dua for you and they will say ameen alongside you. You will be saved from nifaq. And the Prophet ﷺ also described that those people who go to the masjid in the dunya, man ghada il masjid warah, and they come back home, a'adda Allahu fi jannah nuzulun kullama ghada awrah. Allah has prepared a house for these people, especially for those people who constantly go to the masjid and then go back to their homes in the dunya. But most of all, it will make you successful no matter what happens to you. Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهُ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ هُنَفَاءَ وَيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُ الزَّكَاةَ وَذَلِكَ دِينُ قَيِّمَةَ بارك الله لي ولكم في الوحيين أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Brothers and sisters, fear Allah by doing what makes you better and leaving what makes you weaker. Amma ba'd. My brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that the world is going to become even more corrupt. The fitna is going to get even worse as we get closer to the end of the world. And from the very first things that will happen, people will lose their salat. Or they will pray, but they will not know how to pray. Or they will pray, but they will not know why they are praying. People will pray salat whilst their iman is weak, whilst they are spiritually lazy, and even in the worst case scenario, they have nifaq and they don't actually have iman in their hearts. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, "Man sarrahu an yalqa Allah ghadan musliman." Whoever wants to meet Allah as a Muslim tomorrow, despite the fitna that is going to happen as generations go by, let him regularly perform his salat when the call is given for them. This is guidance, Ibn Mas'ud said, radiallahu anhu. And if you pray in your homes, then he has abandoned the way of your Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَلَوْ تَرَكْتُمْ sunnah, and if you leave the sunnah of your Nabi, لَدَلَلْتُمْ, you will become misguided. He said, Ibn Mas'ud, radiallahu anhu, at the time of the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I didn't see anyone who stayed behind and didn't pray their salat properly, illa munafiqun ma'lumun nifaq, except that he was a munafiq and we didn't regard him as being a believer, and this was a clear indication of his nifaq. My brothers and sisters, We have to say, and it's become very unfortunate, but it's real, that many homes don't have people in them who establish the salat. But without salat, my brothers and sisters, how can we be a group of people who identify ourselves as Muslim? How can we know what Islam is and what Islam wants from us? How can we ever be successful when we are not being obedient to our Creator? Allah says in the Quran, "Hafidhu ala salawat," protect your prayers. "Wasalatul wusta wa qumu lillahi qanitin." If you stand, you will be of those who are obedient. Not praying at all, my brothers and sisters, whether a person is lazy or if he is negligent, is a very different and a very difficult situation. Because such a person has not only left the second pillar of Islam, but the ulama are in complete consensus that if a person leaves the salat altogether, he has actually even left the very first pillar of Islam just by leaving the salat. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Bain al-rajul wa bain al-kufri wa shirk," the difference between a person and kufr and shirk and leaving Islam, tarkus salat, is abandoning the prayer. So how can a group of people ever say they believe in Allah but never worship Him? How can a group of people ever become better without knowing who they are worshipping? How can a group of people ever get closer to their Lord and become better people themselves when they don't realize that their Lord, who is most perfect in His names and attributes, wants to teach them from His names and attributes so that they can become better people? Isn't our tawheed ar-rububiyyah connected to our uluhiyyah? Isn't it that if we don't have any rububiyyah, we will not have any uluhiyyah? Isn't it that without uluhiyyah, a person can never have rububiyyah? There's a lot to work on, my brothers and sisters. But now we are entering into the month of Sha'ban, and Ramadan is very, very close. And this is a great chance for us to reform ourselves. These are the days of piety and patience. And through our connection with Allah, in our salat, in our dhikr, in our dua, in our recitation of the Quran, in anything which brings us close to Allah, is a chance for us to be elevated and become better people with Allah. على صلوا وسلموا رحمكم الله قال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم آمنا في بيوتنا ومجتمعاتنا اللهم أصلح أولادنا واحفظنا جميعا يا رب العالمين اللهم ادفع عنا الغلا والوباء والربا والزنا والزلازل والمهن وسوء الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن اللهم اغفر لموتانا اللهم اشف لمرضانا اللهم تول امرنا اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا اللهم استر عيوبنا اللهم بارك لنا في شعباننا اللهم بلغنا رمضان اللهم ربنا اجعلنا مقيم السلام من ذريتنا ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.